So yeah, if you want to have a play around inside that Zoom, really important for you guys to make note of, if you want to get access to the recording feature, you've got to switch it on. So you've got to go into your admin panel and then go and switch it on to get access to that. It's free until the end of September. And then if you're interested in retaining it, we have some like off the table, super, super secret Google access only behind the curtain discounts for enterprise upgrades. And so if you're at all interested in those, then you should chat to our team. So make sure you're connected with us. You can connect with us via the link here that I'm just going to drop right below. And yeah, have a chat to our team on Facebook if you're at all interested in that. But if you just need to switch it on, you can go into your admin panel and just switch on the Meet recording. It's one of the Enterprise Meet features. And Google have made it free until the end of September, which is very cool. Okay, so we've covered off Meet. Let's come into our next one. And this is back onto Google Drive. Now, again, this is one that I have covered a number of times. Google Drive is super important that you get the permissions right. But most businesses are still doing Google Drive like it's 2015. And what I mean by that is they set up everything inside of My Drive, they set up some folders inside of My Drive, and then they just kind of like share those folders out with their team. However, there's a big problem with using My Drive for sharing things, and that's that you're not always the owner of all of the files that are sitting inside of Google Drive. And we hear this time and time and time and time again. And just in the last few weeks, we've had a customer who's had a major disaster. And part of the challenge in that issue that's actually happened with the customer is that files were saved in someone's Gmail account as the owner rather than the business being the owner with a shared drive set up. Now, these were formerly called team drives. They're now called shared drives. And I will continue talking about them until everyone is using them. Shared drives are your way for you to have full ownership over a company folder so that only you are the one who can control what gets added, what gets deleted, who has access, who can make changes. And when you set up a shared drive, it's a bit like a corporate shared drive inside a corporate server network, right? If you've ever worked in corporate, or maybe you've owned a small business server or a NAS drive, like a network hard drive, right? And you've had those files stored there, and the owner of that device can kind of set who can add things, who can delete things via permissions. Well, shared drives let us do that as well. And so what they let us do is lock down our Google Drive folders so that someone can put a file in, but they're not allowed to take a file out. And so that's the magic of shared drives. You have to be on G Suite Business Edition to get access to that. So if you're right now still paying the $8 a month and you're on the Basic Edition, then you need to go up to the Business Edition. So why is this so important? Why is it critical that we use something like shared drives? Well, if you've got more than one person in your business that you're sharing and collaborating on files with, especially if you are sharing files outside the business to a contractor, to an employee who's maybe working under, I don't know, a different domain, or they're doing some work in a Gmail account. They shouldn't be, but maybe they are. But if you've got anyone who's outside the control of your G Suite accounts, you want to make sure that any files that they're working with and sharing internally don't magically disappear if someone decides to clean up their Google Drive, or they accidentally delete something, or something goes wrong. And so shared drives are a way of controlling that. And you absolutely must be using them. Okay, was that useful? Let me know if that was useful, guys. If it was, just drop a comment below and say, yes, Pete, that was useful. I'm also interested to know, if you've not yet set up a shared drive, why not? Do you not understand it? Have you not got access? If you need more videos on shared drives, check out our YouTube channel. We've got heaps of videos on there. And of course, if you need help, then our team will be happy, more than happy to help you out with that. There is also a process of implementing team drives or shared drives. And what that is actually structuring them correctly and then dragging and dropping all of your data into those shared drives. And so you want to make sure that you get that right so that you have everything nice and protected. Okay, cool. So next one we're going to talk about, the next feature that you should be using is enabling the new chat inside of Gmail. Now, if you haven't already started using it, Google Chat is Google's new, it's kind of like, should I call it an answer to Slack? I'm not quite sure. But it's Google's instant messaging chat platform. It's built for Teams. So it's a bit more like Slack. For those of you who use the very old Hangouts, you would know that that was pretty average and didn't really go anywhere. But here, what we have is a brand new, completely redesigned, completely rebuilt chat platform. And this is built for Teams with different rooms like Slack has. You can have threaded conversations, which is pretty cool as well. Let me open up my team group here and you'll see that we've even got things like Giphy integrations. And you know, if something cool approval happens in an external system, like, I don't know, Infusionsoft, or, you know, a customer gives us a review or something, we can have all automations basically happening inside of our Google Chat. Now, this is a great tool, but you had to have yet another tab open. And so what Google have done just in the last week is they've actually integrated the new chat here inside of Gmail. So on the left-hand side of my Gmail, I actually have access to all of my rooms, and I have access to all of my individual chats as well. So if I want to open up a room, I was in our attract room just there, I can go and open up an individual room. Honestly, I don't find that like super, super useful, because it kind of feels like I'm clicking through multiple pages there. But what I like to do instead is I can click this little arrow here, and it actually opens up conversations in a pop-up. So I'll have a conversation pop-up here with Angel. We'll chat back and forward, and then we've got different conversations for the different rooms that I'm a part of. And if I want to open up an individual session, I can open up an individual session. Now, why would you use Google Chat instead of something like Slack, or instead of Facebook Messenger, or instead of email, or instead of Asana? Well, this is really, really useful when you're running remote teams. We have nearly 40 employees on our team, and we need to be able to keep in quick communication. Now, that doesn't mean that we do tasks this way. This is more for, hey, are you free for a meetup later today? Or, hey, I'm running 5 minutes late for the meeting. Jump in and I'll join you in a moment, right? This is for us just keeping in touch with each other. And having to jump to a separate app like Slack or Skype chat, some people still use, and, you know, even having to jump to a different tab is like another kind of jump that we have to do mentally. And what that does is, because multitasking is a myth, it actually distracts us from the work that we're doing. And so Gmail are putting a lot of effort into building this kind of like one ecosystem and one place to do all of your work. You would have seen that on the intro video, that it's all about making sure that you have one simple place to get your work done. Now, I'm a little bit against the idea that your email inbox is the place to get your work done. We did a video previously on how you can like hide the inbox and only show it when you want to, so you don't get distracted by new emails coming in. But what I do like is I now have my calendar on the right-hand side. I've got Google Keep if I need to get access to Google Keep. And now I've got all of my chats here available as well. So if you don't already have access to the new version of Google Chat inside here, like if you're looking at it and it doesn't look like this, maybe you can see some super old conversations there, then again, you need to go and switch this on. So you just jump into your admin panel, go to your chat settings, Gmail settings actually, it may be, and then you can go and switch that on. And if you need any help with that, of course, feel free to get in touch with our team. Okay, cool. So a few people have said, yes, this is useful. Samantha, Chris, Jacinta, awesome. Okay, so Guy said, understanding the principle, but not clear on the process. Okay, thanks for that, Guy. And Darren has said, okay, my Gmail interface still says Hangouts. Is that the same? Darren, that's not quite the same. So you need to go into the admin panel and actually switch on the new chat experience inside of Gmail. You'll find that. It's hidden away in there somewhere under the either the Gmail settings or the chat settings. So have a look through there and you'll find it. And so that was only released about a week ago. If you don't see it inside your account, might not have been rolled out to you just yet. But yeah, if you're getting stuck, just let us know. Okay, cool. So let's move on to our next one, guys. I want to talk a bit about Calendar. And Calendar, for most people, they kind of say, yeah, I know how to use Calendar. You know, I can add people to events. I can share something with someone. I can share my calendar with my partner. And that's like basic level. I'm going to help you guys go pro. I'm going to show you like two or three features super duper quickly, because I don't have time to go through heaps of them that I love. But I want to show you guys how to go pro with Google Calendar, because Calendar is really, really powerful, particularly as your team grows. Once you get more than 3, 4, 5 people in your business, and you start to have to deal with things like who's on leave today and who's available and am I going to bother this person on a day that they're actually out of the office, and am I going to annoy this person by sending them a meeting invitation rather than just checking their calendar and seeing what time they're available. It's been actually updated here. There's some changes that have been made inside of Google Calendar. I'm going to share some cool things that you can do now, which makes meeting with someone pretty easily. As an example, I often find myself wanting to meet with Angel and or Scott, sometimes Regina as well. And so what I'll do is I'll just kind of like open up their calendar by typing their name in here. Now, you can see that Scott's pretty busy. Let's grab Angel as well. Going to add Angel in here. All of a sudden, it becomes very challenging to be able to find a time between us. And so that's one way of scheduling meetings. But another way of actually scheduling meetings is to open up a blank meeting here. We'll go to more options. And then I can actually put in Angel and Scott here. And then I can click one button and go to suggested times. Now, what that's going to do is that's going to look across all of our calendars and automatically find a time that we are available. If you're more of a visual person, I actually like to click the find a time button, and it will actually take me to both of our calendars. So obviously we've got nothing on today, but here we go. I can find a slot here tomorrow where all three of us are available. What that's going to do is automatically look for anyone who's inside your business, because the calendars will be by default shared with each other and you'll be able to see each other's calendars. Now, does this work outside the company? Yes, but only if someone shared their calendar with you, or if they share their busy free information publicly. So that's one thing that needs to be done. Okay, that's a basic one. Hopefully everyone knows that. That feature's been around forever. That's not the groovy stuff that I want to share with you.